I'll show you now how this digital operational resilience testing policy looks like and how to fill it out to be compliant with DORA EU cybersecurity regulation. Now, in its articles 24 to 27, DORA places a big emphasis on resilience testing, and this policy is important because this is where you actually describe all the main rules for this kind of, I would say, complex testing. Because without such a policy, you wouldn't know who needs to do what, when, and why. Okay, I'm showing now this digital operational resilience testing policy from Advisera's DORA documentation toolkit. So here on the first page, you see that this is where you put some general information about the document. So company logo, company name, code, version, date of the version, author, approver, confidentiality level. And then on the second page, you display the change history. This is where you describe how the document has changed throughout its different versions. And then you have table of contents. And then on the third page, you start with the main part of the document. Now, I'll come back to this main part in a minute. Let me first explain you how the document is structured. So let's go through this table of contents. So purpose, scope, and users. This is where you describe what is the, let's say, main idea of this document, to which areas of your company does it apply to, and also who should read this document. Reference documents. This is where you refer to DORA regulation, but also to applicable CDR, potentially also to ISO 27001 or other cybersecurity standards. And then comes this third part, digital operational resilience testing, general principles for the testing. So this is where you define which kind of elements you have to take into account, what are the general responsibilities, what are other related documents, and so on. And then you define the scope. This is where you define what kind of methods will be used for testing. And I'll show you actually this a little bit later on in the main part of the document. Test planning. This is where you define what are the main elements of each testing and how they are described. Test design and execution. This is where you define who defines particular methods for testing and later on who executes these tests. Threat-led penetration testing, or TLPT. Basically, you have these general requirements. This is where you define some general rules. So let's say how often this needs to be done and so on. And then in 4.2, you describe how the external TLPT testers need to be selected based on certain criteria. And similar thing also for when you're using internal TLPT testers, which is also allowed according to DORA. And then 4.4 describes risk management controls. So how do you overcome the risks of actually performing these kind of tests even on production systems? Section 5 is about reporting, remediation, and attestation. So reporting, so basically what kind of reports need to be created, by whom and how often, to whom they are sent. Remediation, so who is actually in charge of fixing all the problems that were identified during this testing. 5.3, attestation and competent authority involvement. So basically when you have these testing, especially TLPT, you have to notify the competent authority about its results. So this is what you describe here. And 5.4, ongoing reviews. So who is going to review the whole process and basically make improvements to the whole process of testing. Section 6, validity and document management. So this is where you define who is the document owner, how often this document needs to be reviewed, these kind of things. And in section 7, you list all the appendices. So for example, here you would list the digital operational resilience testing program, which you have to write based on this policy. Okay, let's now go to the main part and see how this looks like. So basically purpose, scope, and users. As you can see, this document is basically pre-filled based on DORA and these CDRs. And of course, you can edit and change anything that you like. So users of this document are all employees who take part in resilience, security, risk management, and so on. And basically you could say that all employees, let's say, in the security department. Okay, as simple as that. Something that you can adapt it as you see fit. Reference documents, as you can see, various DORA articles. And on the right-hand side, you have these comments, which actually give you links directly to this particular article in DORA. So basically, this is where you can see the original text of the requirements. A similar thing for CDR, right? So this is a Commission Delegated Regulation 1774, which describes in more detail these resilience testing. And you can also see here the link to this regulation. Okay, when we scroll down, you will see Section 3, where the document starts describing this digital operational resilience testing. Again, as you can see, the text is already pre-filled, mainly based on what the DORA requires. For example, you have to take into account this risk-based approach based on these three elements, and this is how it's required by DORA. Of course, you can change this if you think you can add something, but typically you wouldn't delete something because this is really required. Okay, and then you have this reference to this procedure for corrective actions that will be used to prioritize, classify, and remedy all issues revealed through performance of the test. Of course, you can
can enter here some other documents or some other policy that you're using for remediation. And then whenever you see these square brackets, this is where you have to specify something that is specific for a company. And this is really how you adapt and personalize these documents for your specific circumstances in a company. So this is the job title for digital operational resilience testing, and this person must establish internal validation methodologies to ensure that all identified weaknesses, deficiencies, or gaps are fully addressed. And then you have these comments that actually suggest you who this could be. So what is the job title of this person? Usually this is the chief information security officer or business continuity manager. So let's say that you, in your case, you have, let's say, business continuity officer, okay? So you basically simply write it like this and you move on. Testing must be performed at least once a year. And again, you see this comment. This is a minimum requirement from DORA. You can set the period to be more often. And then you can see, let's say, once every 6 months. Okay, and you move on. Again, scope of the digital operational resilience testing program. Again, you have this person that you have to insert here. This is basically the same as above here. I'll show you how to automate the writing of these job titles and everything that is repeating. I'll show you this a little bit later on in the video. And then here you have these testing approaches. As you can see, there are several of them. And again, this is basically defined in the DORA. Test planning, again, this job title must propose the annual digital operational resilience testing by the start of each year. Again, you can simply adapt this by the, let's say, June 30th each year. And this is basically how it looks like. This is how you fill out the document and adapt it for your specific processes and people and technology in your company.
Now, as a consequence of this policy, you'll have to make various decisions around which methods of testing you will be using, what is the scope, how to design the testing itself, whether you're going to use the threat-led penetration testing, and so on. And these decisions are usually made between the person who is in charge of this policy, and this is typically chief information security officer, and also other technical personnel that you have in the company. So starting from the CTO to, let's say, head of the IT department, also technical specialists within the company. So you basically have to reach a consensus on what is really needed to perform a comprehensive testing of your systems. Of course, you will also have to involve your senior management, because the sponsor of your cybersecurity in the company, which is typically a senior executive, this person needs to know and in some cases needs to decide on various dilemmas or options that are available. Now, of course, the biggest challenge here is to bring all these people together and, first of all, for them to understand the importance here, and also, second, getting them to make these decisions in a reasonable amount of time, but also that these decisions really make sense. With regards to raising awareness, you have to explain them what is the purpose of this document, and that without this document you wouldn't really be compliant with DORA, but it also that this testing must be done and that it's more efficient to do it in a planned way rather than in some chaotic way, which would take much more time and resources. And also there is the challenge of finding time to write this document, so I'm going to show you now how to use this document wizard from DORA documentation toolkit that will speed up the writing of this document.
So this is how this DORA documentation toolkit application looks like once you log in. So to look for this policy, we should scroll down to this folder 13, digital operational resilience testing. When you open it, here you see this digital operational resilience testing policy. So let's click on it. And then we start actually using this wizard. So basically this wizard here is to speed up the writing of this policy. And I'll show you now how this is done. So here you have a set of questions which you should be answering. So what is the name of the person to approve this document, let's say John Smith? What is the confidentiality level for this document? It says internal use. And basically these fields are already pre-populated because I used this wizard for some other documents from DORA toolkit. And then the application remembered what I entered. And then it suggests for each new document, it suggests already the most likely entries here. So let's say that I don't want internal use, that I want, let's say, confidential. And I simply move on to the next step. What is the job title of the person in charge of digital operational resilience testing in your company? So let's say this is business continuity manager. As you can see, it's already suggested here as one of the entries. Okay, and we move on next. What is the job title of the person in charge of overseeing security? CTO, it's fine. Who is in charge of managing security? CISO, already this is suggested because I entered these things earlier. Who is the owner? CISO, fine. What is the job title of the person to approve this document? CEO. But now I'm done with this wizard, and then I click here, download, and in a couple of seconds, I'll be able to download the document on my disk. So when I open this document, you will see this is basically the same document, but it's already pre-filled through this wizard. So you already see here this logo and the company name. And this is something that also the wizard remembers from previous documents that I enter there. Approver, John Smith. This is what I entered through the wizard. Confidentiality level, confidential, the same thing. Here you see this company name and the confidentiality level in the header. And so let's see the rest of the document. So let's see what the wizard has pre-filled here. Yeah, so here, business continuity manager. As you can see, this is what I entered through the wizard because this is going to be the person who is in charge of doing this. Also here, you see business continuity manager is in charge of business continuity manager determines. So basically all the placeholders where I needed to enter this specific job title who is in charge of testing, it's already automatically inserted here. So therefore, this kind of a wizard speeds up considerably the writing of this kind of a document.
Hope this was helpful. And to see for yourself this digital operational resilience testing policy, sign up for a free trial of DORA documentation toolkit. Click the link in the description below and you'll be able to see a free demo of this document, but also of other documents from this toolkit. And you'll also be able to try how this document wizard works. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. And you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel not to miss any of my new videos. And I publish videos every week. Thanks for watching.